हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर केमिस्ट्री लेक्चर अब चैप्टर नंबर 4, कार्बन एंड इट्स कंपाउंड. सो इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द कार्बन एंड इट्स कंपाउंड. सो वी नो दैट अमंग द होल कंपाउंड इन यूनिवर्स देयर मोस्ट ऑफ कंपाउंड्स आर मेड अप ऑफ कार्बन. देयर आर 90% कंपाउंड्स विच आर मेड अप ऑफ ओनली बाय यूजिंग कार्बन. So that means carbon is very special element so that it can make this type of various type of compounds. So the question is there arise why the carbon shows the versatile nature, why carbon has having the special property to make the various type of compounds. So why it can be we will discuss here about the versatile nature of carbon. So what is mean by versatile nature? Versatile nature of carbon means it can make various types of compound having different chemical properties. So why it is? So it can make various type of compound by combining with various atoms like hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, chlorine, iodine and etc. With various atoms it can combine and make compound. So it is the property of carbon. And the second property is it can also make the bond with itself and with other atom as well to give stable compound. और जो bond बनता है उसका carbon का जो bond बनता है अपने खुद के साथ भी और दूसरे एटम के साथ भी वो बॉन्ड बहुत ही ज्यादा स्टेबल होता है एज कंपेयर टू अनदर एलिमेंट्स इन द 14 ग्रुप. सिलिकॉन, जर्मेनियम लाइक दिस एलिमेंट्स आर आल्सो प्रेजेंट इन 14 ग्रुप एंड कार्बन इज आल्सो देयर. बट कार्बन शोज द वर्सटाइल नेचर अमंग दोज एलिमेंट्स. सो व्हाई इट इज? सो दीज आर टू रीजंस फॉर इट. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट कार्बन इज हैविंग द स्पेशल प्रॉपर्टी to form various type of compound. So first is carbon is tetravalent. Second is carbon show catenation, that is the special property of carbon. And third one is kinetic inertness. So we will discuss here one by one this special property of carbon because of which it shows the versatile nature. So first is it is tetravalent. It is the benefit of carbon that it is tetravalent. Means what is mean by tetravalent? It is having valency 4. Means its combined capacity is 4. Means it can make 4 bonds. It can make 4 bonds with another atoms or with cell itself also. So like that 4 bonds it can make. So it is having space to form 4 bonds. That is the tetravalent. Okay, the second property is catenation. Second property is catenation. So what is mean by catenation? So catenation means it is a tendency to form long chain of carbon as like C, it is the long chain. Here we can see the long chain is formed by the carbon and this property of carbon is very special property. Silicon also can form the long chain. But this long chain is not as stable as the chain formed by the carbon atom. And that means it gives the stable chain. And also the chain may be double bonded and it may be triple bonded also. Means the one more property we can say here, carbon is having, it can make carbon-carbon single bond, carbon-carbon double bond, carbon-carbon triple bond as well. So there are some example of single bond. First is ethane. Ethane is one of the hydrocarbon, well known hydrocarbon. So chemical formula of ethane is C2H6. It is the having ane functional group. We will discuss about it later on. So the structure of ethane is carbon-carbon single bond is here, and here one bond means one electron of carbon is shared by itself and the rest of three electrons are shared with three hydrogen atoms, each carbon atom is having one bond with itself and three bond with hydrogen atom. Thus, the structure is made by the ethane is carbon-carbon single bond and three rest of three bonds are with hydrogen atoms for each carbon atom here. So, next is the double bond structure. The example is ethene. It is N. Ethena, that is single bond. It is ethena. E means double bond. E means double bond. So, here we can see the chemical formula C2H4. And under this chemical formula, C2H4, carbon, carbon, both that two carbon atoms are bonded with the double bond. So, here two electrons are engaged here to form the double bond. And the rest of two electrons are bonded, are shared with two hydrogen atoms to give the structure of ethene. So, the next one we will see the structure of ethyne. So, Y and E, it is means triple bond. It is means triple bond. So, in this structure, the chemical formula is C2H2. Here, two carbon atoms are bonded with triple bond. Means three electrons of carbon are shared with the three electrons of other carbon atoms to give carbon-carbon triple bond. And the rest of electron is bonded by covalent bond with hydrogen. Here also one hydrogen, here also one hydrogen. So, all that two carbons are fulfill its four valency. Here also that both carbon atoms are fulfilled their four valency, two here and two here. Here we know each carbon atom is fulfilled by its bonding with one carbon-carbon bond and three hydrogen bond. So that is about single bond, double bond and triple bond. That also we have discussed. This is the special property of carbon. And the next is kinetic inertness. So what is mean by inertness? In 9th standard also we have seen inert gases. What is mean by inert gases? These are inactive gases. So their valency for inert gases, their valency is zero. Means they are inert, means they don't need any atom for the bonding, any electron for the bonding. Its valence shell is fulfilled with the minimum capacity of or maximum capacity of electrons. So, they are called inert gases. So, inertness, the word is inactive. The meaning of inert is inactive. So, carbon compound also show the kinetic inertness, means the compounds made by the carbon, they are inert. They are inert means they don't get break down easily, not to attract another atoms. मतलब वो कार्बन के जो कंपाउंड्स है वो इजीली ब्रेक नहीं होते, उसके जो कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड्स है वो इजीली ब्रेक नहीं होते हैं और दूसरे एटम्स को अटैक भी नहीं करते हैं और अट्रैक्ट भी नहीं होते उसके तरफ. मतलब वो इनएक्टिव है, एक्टिव नहीं है ज़्यादा. मतलब सिलिकॉन भी कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड बनाता है, चेन भी बनाता है, लेकिन वो चेन जल्दी ब्रेक हो जाती है. Because the silicon-silicon covalent bond is very active, it is reactive, so that it break down early and again it will make a different type of compound. But in case of carbon, the compound made here, these are stable. And why these are stable? Because these compounds are inert, kinetically inert, means they are inactive. So, this is the again one special property of carbon. Because of this property, the carbon compounds are stable. So, I hope you understood why the carbon shows versatile nature, because of its tetravalent property, because its catenation means the tendency to make the long chain and the stable long chain again. And it can make double bond, single bond, double bond as well, triple bond. So, we have seen here, we have discussed here the three type, three structures of three bonds, three types of bonds here. So we will go to our next topic. Under those topic we will discuss what are organic compound. What are organic compound? So we know that organic chemistry and organic compound, we heard this word many times. We heard this word many times. But what is mean by organic compound? And why the carbon compounds are called organic compound? So in our early age, it is assumed that carbon compounds are extracted only by the only from the living organism. मतलब कार्बन कंपाउंड्स जो है वो सिर्फ लिविंग कंपाउंड से ही हम निकाल सकते हैं, एक्सट्रैक्ट कर सकते हैं, ऐसा एजम्पशन था पहले के एज में, पहले के जमाने में. लेकिन वन साइंटिस्ट फ्रेडरिक वुलर इन 1828 वन साइंटिस्ट फ्रेडरिक वुलर ही प्रिपेयर्ड वन आर्टिफिशियल हाइड्रोकार्बन आर्टिफिशियल कार्बन कंपाउंड इन इट्स लैब. एज द साइंटिस्ट प्रिपेयर्ड वन आर्टिफिशियल कंपाउंड इन इट्स लैब एट आफ्टर दैट इट इज प्रूव्ड द कार्बन कंपाउंड्स कैन बी मेड इन द लैब. वी कैन मेक द कार्बन कंपाउंड इन लैब, दैट इज प्रूव्ड. सो द फर्स्ट एजम्पशन वॉज डिनाइड that the carbon compound can only be extracted from the living organism. So what is mean by organic compound? That is related to living organism. But it is proved later on it can make by the experiment or by the artificial combination, sorry. So the scientist in Friedrich Wöhler, he prepared urine by using ammonium cyanide. So here he prepared urine. This is the structure of urine. So that scientist in 1828 prepared urine in its lab from the ammonium cyanide. This is ammonium cyanide. So by his experiment he prepared urine, and from that experiment it is proved that we can make carbon compound artificially as well. So this is about the organic compounds. So after that we will go to our next topic, that are hydrocarbons. So we know carbon compounds, the compounds made up of carbon, these are called carbon compounds. So what is mean by hydrocarbon then? What is mean by hydrocarbon? So hydrocarbon What is mean by hydrocarbon? Hydrocarbons are those compound which are made up of by using carbon and hydrogen. Carbon and hydrogen. By combining, by reacting carbon and hydrogen, it may be included another atom also, but specially when it is formed by using carbon and hydrogen, this type of compounds are called hydrocarbons. So these hydrocarbons are having various type. So these hydrocarbons are various type. So types of hydrocarbon we will see here. Types of hydrocarbon. How many types of hydrocarbons are there? There are many types of hydrocarbon. One is aliphatic hydrocarbon. Second one is cyclic. I will write at this side. because we have to draw here structure also. Cyclic hydrocarbon. So these are the mainly two types of hydrocarbon. So under these aliphatic hydrocarbons, again two types are there. Under this, one is saturated hydrocarbon, and again another is unsaturated hydrocarbon. And here under the cyclic, here cycloalkane. One is the cycloalkane. And second one is arene. We will discuss in detail what is mean by saturated hydrocarbon, that we will discuss first. Hydrocarbons are divided into two types. One is aliphatic hydrocarbon, second one is cyclic hydrocarbon. Again, the aliphatic hydrocarbon is divided into saturated hydrocarbon and unsaturated hydrocarbon here. And that cyclic hydrocarbon also is divided into cycloalkane and arene. So first we will discuss about saturated. Saturated means all valencies are saturated here. All valencies are saturated here by using only single bond. If single bond is there, all bonds are saturated. That means all bonds are saturated. One example just now we have seen here. What is that example? What was that example? Alkane. Under the alkane, we have seen ethane, methane. The first compound of alkane group is methane. Second is ethane. So we will see first the structure of methane, CH4. That is methane. CH4 means 4 H are bonded with carbon by covalent bond. So here 4 covalent bonds are formed by carbon with hydrogen atom, and each and every bond is single bond. There is no double bond. Every bond is single bond. Means these are hydrogen atoms are bonded with single bond with carbon atom. In ethane also, just now we have seen. Two carbons are also bonded here by single bond, and again the 6 hydrogens are also bonded by single bond with its individual carbon atom. So this is about the alkane. N means single bond here. This indicates single bond. So one magic also we will see. 1, 2, 3, 4 you have learned in your life. Now we will learn 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 10 here in chemistry. How the 1, 2, 3, 4 is written here. Methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane and decane. This is the 1, 2, 3, 4 of chemistry. Methane means single, means first one, two means ethane means two carbon atom, methane means one carbon atom, ethane means two carbon atoms, propane means three carbon atom, butane means four carbon atom. Like that whole series will come here. Like later on I will show that series. Methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane and decane. Means for propane three carbon atom bonded, butane four carbon atoms are bonded. Like that series will be form here. So after that, the second type of aliphatic hydrocarbon is unsaturated. Under this unsaturated hydrocarbon, there is double bond and triple bond. We'll come here. Under this double bond, just now we have seen that also C2H4, that is ethene. In means double bond. Here two carbon atoms are bonded by double bond and the four hydrogen atoms are bonded by single bond with two individual carbon atom. So it means two carbon atoms are present here, that's why it is called ethane. So similarly we will see the triple bond. The example is C2H2, that is ethyne, I means triple bond, I means here triple bond. So here carbon bond is the triple bond, and again only two hydrogen are here. So one is bonded here and one is bonded here. So like this structure ethyne will show. So this is about the saturated hydrocarbon. Example is methane and second example is ethane. So again under the unsaturated hydrocarbon there are two types, again double bond and triple bond. Unsaturated means what? The carbon atoms are not bonded by single bond. There is unsaturation, that's why it is bonded with double bond, either it is bonded with triple bond as well. So it is unsaturated. The saturated bonds are more stable. Saturated bonds are stable here, and these are unstable. That's why these are not reactive, and these are reactive. These are less reactive, and these are reactive as well. So this is about aliphatic hydrocarbon. So after that we will see cyclic hydrocarbon. So carbon also get bonded in cyclic form. This means hydrocarbons are found, the carbon compound means hydrocarbons are also found in cyclic form. If we have taken here pentane, aliphatic pentane. What is aliphatic pentane? The structure of aliphatic pentane. See, it is five carbon atoms are bonded. So this cycloalkane we will see in our next lecture. Especially we will see the cyclic hydrocarbon. Under that cycloalkane and arene we will discuss. Up to that, do you have to read this topic from your textbook? And be ready for your next topic, cyclic hydrocarbon, that we will see in our next lecture. Thank you. It's okay. Awaaz barabar hai.